Today I'm going to show you how to use the Gravity PDF Bulk Generator add-on once you've got it installed on your website. So we've got our demo site here. The plugin is already installed and activated. And we've got our form here with a bunch of different fields on it. We want to make sure we have our PDFs set up right. So I'm going to head to Settings PDF. And on this form we've got three PDF setup using our formal letter template. They're named here, just a standard one without a signature and one with a signature. Now on this one with no signature, we've actually got it set up with conditional logic, so it won't be generated for all the entries, only the ones that match this condition. In this case, the business email has to contain the text gravitypdf.com. Once you've got your PDF set up, you can head to the entries list page. And from here, you want to double check that you can view the individual PDFs without any issues. If you did have any issues viewing them, they'll need to be corrected before you'll be able to bulk generate those same PDFs. So I've just checked all three. They look fine. Standard letters. And they're displaying without any problems. So the bulk generator add-on's been integrated into Gravity Forms native bulk actions features. So if we hit the bulk actions select box, right down the bottom there's this new option, download PDF. If you've used the bulk actions before, you go and select the entries you want using these little checkboxes, and then select the bulk action option you want and hit the apply button. So you can go through and select the individual ones, or we can use the select all box to select everything on this page. There's also the ability to select everything on all the pages. So there's actually 27 entries on this form. And it's split over two pages because it's only showing 20 per page. I'm going to select all 27 for this demo. We've got download PDF already selected here and we'll hit apply. So this is the configure pop-up box that allows you to control which PDFs you actually want to bulk generate. So you can see all three here and I can toggle individual PDFs on or off, or I can toggle them all. So I'm going to select them all. But you can pick and choose whatever you want to do. The directory structure setting is the path that gets used and where the PDFs are saved in the generated zip file. So once this process finishes, you'll get a zip file with all your PDFs included. And this directory structure tells the PDFs where they should be saved in that zip package. It's a great way to organize your PDFs so you don't have to just get them all in one folder and then have to sort them and group them based on what information was entered in the form. So we've got some common tags here. We can sort them by year and month, date, and even hour if you've got a heavy traffic system, and minute as well. Or we could group them by payment status. So if you capture payment through PayPal or Stripe, it could group the PDFs via if they've been paid, they've been refunded, the transaction's processing, it's been void or cancelled, so you can group the PDFs that way. You've also got the entry ID, so each entry will have its own folder. And another useful one is the user information, so we could group it by the logged in user who submitted that entry, or their email or display name on your site. So if you have a bunch of users who are logged into your site and they fill out the form. You could bulk generate them, sort them by those users, and it's a great way to get yourself easily organized. But this box isn't just limited to these common tags. You can use any of your form merge tags here. So if I wanted to include the business name, I can include the business name merge tag here, and I'll group via all these values. I can also put in static names. So if I wanted business names /PDFs, then group them by year and month, I could do that as well. So it's just a nice, easy way to group and sort your PDFs into folders so you don't have to do it yourself. For this test, I think I'm going to just start off with grouping them by entry ID, have a more flat structure. It'll just give us a lot more folders to have a look at. You know what, I might even do entry ID and then the year, or let's scratch that, we'll do year first, then entry ID. And when we hit the build, it's going to take us to the second step. We've got this nice progress indicator that's going to tell us how far through the build it's come out of 100. Now, while you're waiting, don't navigate away from this page. You'll need to leave your browser window open until you download the completed zip file. You can open it up at the tab and go do your normal browsing and then come back once it finishes. We're halfway now. You might have noticed these logs down here. So success, 34 PDFs, warning 17. So if I toggle open the success box, we can see exactly which PDFs are generated for which particular entries. And I can scroll down there and have a look. The success ones, you know, just an indicator that they've been completed. It's the warnings or the errors that you'd be more interested in taking a look at. Once we get to the third step, download, it's automatically going to prompt you to save your zip file. Now, this is dependent on your browser settings. If you've configured it to auto-download your zip files, then it'll just automatically start downloading and save to a local folder on your computer. Otherwise, you'll be prompted to save it. So I'm actually going to just hit cancel for that for a minute, and we'll come back to the logs. So the logs are also shown on the download screen, so if you miss it on the build screen, you can review what occurred. So we had 55 successful PDFs, which is great. But we had 26 warnings. So I'm going to toggle them open, and it's going to give us why the warning occurred. So at the start here, it says conditional logic check. We've skipped the formal letter without a signature. That was the one that I showed you we had conditional logic on for entry 580. As you saw at the start, only the entries with the business email gravitypdf.com included were going to get generated. And we have a quick look down the list here. I can't see any others besides this one, the second one. So it makes sense that we have 26 skipped. We should be able to find, if we do a little search here, for this entry ID, this PDF ID, which is unique to the PDFs on the form. We should find, here we go, a success on, it's going to be this entry, 579, and doesn't look like there's any more. So it's just the one. And that's just something to be mindful of. If you know you've got your conditional logic set up for those PDFs, then it's just something that you can ignore because that's expected. If You weren't expecting this. You would look and have a look at this PDF and go and find out why there's conditional logic on it and why it's not working for these particular entries. So I cancelled the download before, but I want to download it now. So we've got this link here where we can click it and re-download it. So I'm going to open that zip file. So we grouped it by year and then entry ID. So we got 27 folders, and in that we can see the generated PDFs for this particular entry, which is excellent, exactly what we wanted. In this one, the raw user data, entry submission data is going to be up here. DINCOM, which is our first one. If I go back to this next one, we have our three, which is going to be our Supercore business. I can open those up. You can see this one's got Supercore. And we've got our no signature PDF here as well, which isn't present in any of the other ones. So if we don't actually use any folders, I'm going to close this up and we'll go and pick a handful to generate again. I'll just do these four. I'll select all three of those. And I'm not going to have a folder this time. I'm just going to leave it in the root. When we hit build now, we'll get a warning about the conditional logic check again. And everything else, fingers crossed, will succeed. Okay, so we've got three warnings, which are for the three entries that the condition didn't pass, and obviously passing on the Supercore. So this is all in the root. Now, because we've got the same exact name for each of our PDFs, you'll notice that some of these have been appended with some numbers. This is actually the entry ID and then a shortened version of the PDF ID included at the end. And this is so that we don't override any of the existing files if there's a naming conflict. And this is why we encourage the use of organizing your PDFs into folders. But you've got the option there. If you didn't actually want to include this number at the end, you want to try and make the file name as unique as possible by using merge tags. So we could go back to our PDF settings now and say for this first one, formal letter, we might decide that we want to add in the business name. And then we'll go back to our entries now, and we'll go and regenerate the PDF for those first four entries. We'll make it five. What's life without whimsy? Okay, so we've selected five, and we brought up the prompt again. I'm just going to download the formal letter, the first one that we just changed, and have everything saved to the root directory. So build should only take 30 seconds. There we go. Not even that. Okay, so now we've got our five PDFs, and they don't have those numbers at the end anymore because they've got the business name at the end, and they're all unique names, so it didn't need to include the entry ID and the PDF ID at the end. It's only going to do that if it detects a naming conflict. And that's basically it. There is documentation on the other warnings that you might get or errors that you might encounter on gravitypdf.com. And you can go through and read all about those. If you have any questions, fill in a support request form, and one of our tech team will get back to you as soon as they are available. Thank you.